So we're back again with another interview with some awesome artists. We have a concept artist, and I'm going to drop it anyways, an art director from Gearbox. You are freelance, but you also do a lot of stuff at Sideshow, correct? Yeah. So again, it was Scott and Richard. Yep. So you can find them stuff. We'll talk about that later. But why are you guys here today at Industry Giants 2018?
Well, we were asked here to come up, look at some portfolios, cool. Give some critique, portfolio reviews with some of the,
So is it kind of like a speed thing, almost like speed dating, where you're like, you know, come up, hey, huh, how are you? Nice. A little awkward at first, you know, and then you shut them down and then they leave. Like,
I don't know.
A little bit. Yeah, like 10 minutes.
So we had some time.
Yeah. There's a group of three of us artists, and we would kind of all give our input into one artist to try to help them out.
Which was kind of nice because you got.
Oh, so it's three at once. So cool.
Yeah,
awesome.
So it was cool.
Did you see any like potential good stuff, or was it all kind of
some good stuff?
No.
Just all.
Yeah, no.
Start working.
You guys all suck. Try harder.
Yeah.
That's good. But some good stuff.
Well, cool. So you both do digital, then I'm assuming, as far as like matte painting, concepting, things like that. Or what's your forte? What is your specialty? What do you love doing, I guess? Very open ended, I guess. So you first.
I personally do a lot of character art.
Okay.
But I also love creating, I was like keyframes for movies and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So I love creating mood,
nice.
Telling a story. That's the main bulk of my work.
And so for Sideshow, what do you freelance there? Is it statues or what do you?
Yeah, so I do the character designs, the statue designs for the characters.
Gotcha.
So
like the flat 2D or do you actually sculpt?
2D.
Well? Okay.
So I'll do the costume designs, mm-hmm. the character designs, the poses,
nice.
And the base designs, all that kind of stuff.
Okay.
So pre-production.
Are there any that you can talk about that you've worked on?
I think I've been there for about 2.5 years now.
Nice.
And the only things that have been announced so far have been, there's a new Doomsday.
Nice.
Okay. Maquette.
Yeah.
There's an X-23 statue, okay. And a Batman vs. Superman.
Wait, so you've been there for 2.5 years and they're just now announcing some of these things? Like,
yeah.
They do it way in advance?
It's just like video games.
It takes a while.
Wow,
right?
Okay.
I never realized that.
That's crazy.
Yeah, so if I do something, it's going to take 2 years before I get to actually show
it. Wow. Do you have like a bunch in your house or anything? Or no?
I do.
Yeah.
I'm a big nerd, big geek.
Yeah.
I collected it before I started working for them, actually. I was already a big fan.
Match made
it.
Yeah, totally.
Do you collect Funko Pops like on the side? Like,
absolutely not.
You're like, no, those
are toys. I collect statues.
Sorry. I have a bunch of everything, so that's why it's just so
awesome.
So, I also have a 3-year-old son, so he loves, I'm like, no, those are daddy's toys. Those. But statues are awesome. That's super cool. So over at Gearbox, then what are you mostly in charge of? Or like, what do you do character as well?
Yeah, so most people know me. I did all the character designs in the Borderlands franchise.
Okay.
Except
Claptrap.
I did. Lauren, who lives local, he did Claptrap, but I did a lot of the character designs there. A lot of the kind of got to put a lot of touch on the style of the game there,
okay.
And my art director on the franchise now.
So. Yeah, so you get to kind of direct the way that's going, the mood, lighting, and stuff like that. So that's
mm-hmm.
pretty cool. Like, you know, your vision.
I was the art director of it didn't fare as well as we wanted it to. Battleborn.
Oh yeah.
Which kind of unfortunately some other game I think was kind of big beat us pretty bad.
But
you know. So we did that one, and again, just very character-driven game.
Yeah.
So, I'm a big fan of characters, and just, I'm obsessed with creating more of them and stuff.
Unique personalities,
all that fun
stuff. So do you have a favorite character from one of your games you've worked on?
Some I can't talk about. The ones I can talk about, I've always been pretty partial to Zero or Salvador from Borderlands 2.
Yeah. So, yeah, no, he's a fun guy.
Yeah, I like those guys, so.
So do you have a favorite sculpt or bust or anything, or like a statue that you've worked on that you're allowed to talk about, I guess? I know, it's so tough. It's always like navigating. Like, what's going to get strapped on by an NDA?
I have a close place in my heart for Doomsday because it was the first design that I worked on.
Is this based off the movie version, or?
No.
Okay.
No, thank God.
No,
this is...
Because I was going to have some words with you.
It's this guy.
I did it. No, most of the stuff we always try to... keep the comic book feel, but to just put a Sideshow twist on it.
Gotcha. Okay.
So, you know, it's like 80% comic book accurate, and then
gotcha.
We put our own twists.
So do you have some like flexibility to kind of put your own spin on it? Or is
totally.
Yeah. So they encourage that, I guess? Or
I tell everybody I can, like, Sideshow is the best company I've ever worked for.
Nice.
They allow so much flexibility and creativity for the artists. And because, you know, at heart, we want to, like, create, come up with unique ideas.
Exactly.
And not be, like, kept within too much with restraints. So they're really awesome at allowing me to just come up with like as much shit as I stuff as I want. And at that point, it's the first bleep. And then, from there, they're going to art direct me and like kind of whittle stuff down. But
gotcha. Okay. And their sideshow is local then, I guess, to Dallas? Or is
no, they're in California.
So do you freelance out to them, I guess?
Yeah.
That's the part of the freelance.
Yeah, I do freelance. So. I fly out there every once in a while.
Oh, nice. Okay, cool. Yeah. So do you prefer being in studio, or do they have a studio environment, or how does that work?
I feel like this is helpful information. So yeah. As freelance, it's fantastic for the amount of freedom that you get, but it can get kind of tough because you are working secluded, right? Like,
yeah.
So, I mean, I always tell people, like, I feel kind of like a hermit sometimes. Mm-hmm. I'm in my office all day. When my wife comes home from work, I'm like, oh my God.
Yeah, people. You're
home, like human contact.
No.
But then getting to work in a studio environment, you have less freedom. But man, being able to be around tons of other creatives are every day, it's awesome because it rubs off on you.
It's good to take both ways, though.
Yeah,
sometimes you're like, get away from me.
So
there's a blessing and a curse on both sides of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I totally agree. I mean, and time management is a huge thing. You'd be like, I can wake up at 10 today. It's fine.
Yeah. Not everybody could do freelance for that reason.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you have to be able to stay on task.
Yeah.
And I feel like a lot of students or people are like, oh, I'll just be freelance. It's like, I mean, if you haven't built those time management skills, like at a studio, I mean, it's very punctual, and if you don't have that skill set, then it can go bad really quickly. So
yeah, definitely.
I did freelance for a little while, and it was like 11:30. I'm like, oh, I'm not even up yet. This is bad. But then again, you could stay up till 2 a.m. or 3 a.m. working on stuff. You have to manage your own time. So.
True.
But no, it's super cool that you get that flexibility, though. But
yeah.
Meeting with people, like, I'm assuming that's why you like these types of events, because
you're
going to get the re-network, re-link up with people you haven't seen in a while.
Yeah,
and stuff
definitely.
Like that. So have you been to one of these events before here?
Not in Dallas, no. But I keep in contact with everybody in the Dallas area. I feel like we're all like got connected at some point working at some studio here in Dallas, so we all know each other. So. Yeah.
And so, because you're friends, I guess, with more game people then rather than anything else. Because I mean, mostly in Dallas, it's Gearbox and id, and I guess those are two big game studios. I mean, there's like Bottle Rocket and a couple of other. Like,
Playful.
Yeah, Playful, which I've done some stuff for Playful, which was really cool. Their studio in McKinney is pretty fun. So.
Yeah, totally.
But yeah, it's just the camaraderie and stuff. It's very, very fun. But yeah, so that's cool. So you guys did the portfolio review here. You get to kind of network up a little bit. We talk a little bit about what you guys do. What are you looking forward to? Is there anything that you can, I guess you might not be able to talk about that, but. Man, that's kind of tricky. So,
what's your next project?
What's your next project? How about this? Is there a dream project? Like, if you could work on one particular thing, whether it be a movie or a game or a franchise or something like. No, I know there's kind of red tape, but like your studios and stuff. But like, if there's a game franchise or something that you could work on, or one particular character for a sideshow collectible, like what would you work for, or what character would you make if you had the option? Does that make sense?
It's always tricky for me.
I know,
because. I would go the thing that no one's seen yet that I'm trying to make
myself,
right? But of pre-existing things, a lot of the things that I love the most, I don't want to touch because I'll destroy them.
Well, <you're just>
like Zelda, like no, I'm not gonna do it.
No,
like you know, but there's some things like I would love to. This is kind of an odd answer given the games I've made, but I'd love to make a Star Fox game.
Yeah, really? I mean, that's still cool.
I'm a big fan of stylized stuff, Jet Grind, Jet Set Radio, and stuff like things like that would be really fun to play in, but. It's usually kind of left to center, kind of like whatever, but...
I guess you're working on stuff that's more adult nature, more dark, like you want to do something more kind of fun and playful, I guess. So, I mean, it makes sense.
So, it's kind of like, there's just so much cool stuff out there that you could touch, but some things I just don't want to because of the sometimes the fan base.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Because it'd be like, Star Wars, or no, I don't want to touch it, because...
They'll just get murdered online.
Yeah.
That art director changed the color.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, oh man, jeez. So, do you have a character that if you had the opportunity to work on?
Character, not so much. I've gotten to work on quite a bit for Sideshow through that. Stuff I really enjoy doing the most, like I was saying before, is more narrative stuff. So,
yeah.
Hopefully I continue working on films. I think doing, I guess, just more horror stuff, because I do a lot of creature design
really?
And horror
okay,
stuff.
Cool.
So, yeah.
The scarier, really the better, basically.
But it's all about atmospheric, right?
Yeah.
Like, not necessarily about slasher, like
jump
scare
mood
stuff.
And tonal, that kind of thing.
Yeah, I love doing that stuff. So.
Perfect. That's super cool.
Yeah.
So I guess since it is for like a lot of students and stuff, are there any like tips or tricks, or what would you, if you could change something that you did in your career, like say, I wish I would have applied at this place, or I wish I would have, did this tutorial on this sooner, maybe. And that's kind of open-ended, I know, but like, is there anything, or do you feel like you went like where you went meant to be? Like, is that
kind of? I mean, I went to a community college.
Yeah.
I'm from Kansas, Kansas City. I went to a community college there. They had no thing like education today. There was nothing that was like, you know, I took design stuff, 2D design, which I actually am so grateful for doing. I think a lot of people are looking for shortcuts, you know, and they're like, just get me to the thing that gets me there. But I think without a foundation, if you want to do concept design, I feel like 2D design is so important because it's shapes and scale and relation and like silhouettes and things. It's not just about rendering, you know, it's not just about how many things can I, throw together in one image a lot too. I mean, there's different kinds of things, but I think to me, it's just like, to just don't underestimate the foundation fundamentals.
Because if you don't understand composition,
of anatomy, of light and color, and
or tone, like you were saying,
it's super important. I mean, it's some of the same feedback we get today,
Totally.
you know, as we're looking at things like, oh, you're, I feel like a lot of people are just trying to like cut to the front of line, and like you can tell when someone's put the work in, or dug into what that thing is. And I think too, it's not a bad thing to target a handful of things to go towards people that try to do everything. I mean, jack of all trades, master of none. You know, I see it in my own work too. Mm-hmm. You know, I try to do too much and sort of, you know, bring it back. And I just think some focus and just try not to skimp on fundamentals. There's so many tutorials online, or classes or things that you can watch. And that's what I would kind of, prompt people to do.
Yeah.
Well, one other thing too, not to keep talking. I think there's a fine line between like, I'm a fan of something and I can actually do it.
Yeah.
And I think just because you watch like this that much, or you love comics this much, it doesn't mean like that always translates into your physical capability of
doing that.
And I think sometimes, but you can still find a position in that, like maybe I become a producer that works alongside of people that do that, and I can still have a hand in that. And I just think that's an important thing that I see that a lot. Like, I've loved this my entire life. It doesn't mean it's you're fit to do that, but there's probably a job within that industry that allows you to make that.
I mean, that makes perfect sense. Like, I mean, you don't want to get discouraged, because I mean, if you do love something, like, I mean, I was telling Brett, like, I wanted to do character and creature modeling. I loved it. I wasn't bad at it, but I wasn't great at it. And I knew I wasn't going to be great at it, so I steered more towards the commercial side. You know, so you kind of have to understand your strengths and weaknesses and know that you can't be perfect at everything, and that you could still be an artist and not.
Competition's fierce.
It is. It's crazy fierce. So, I mean, it's intense. So.
So give up on your dreams?
Yeah, exactly. Just squash everything and
I don't mean that.
Like, bartending, it's a good thing to do. So,
I don't know. I think people need to like not like just believe in yourself and you can do anything. That's not always true.
No, yeah.
You know, but I think you can find a way to contribute to those things that you love, you know. And I don't mean to be negative towards that, but like sometimes you've got it or you don't have it.
Yeah.
So then you just, I think it's, you know, work and see where you can get. I know I've never felt like I had it. I still don't feel like I have it. I still continue to work at it, and there's always somebody better than me.
Imposter syndrome, I think, is what it's called.
Oh, yeah. Like, everybody's better, you know?
I feel like that's always a really good thing to keep in mind, is that, like, there's always going to be somebody better than you.
Yeah. And if you think there isn't, then you should just stop, probably, because you've lost it.
so I guess one last question then. Do you have anyone that you guys look up to? Like, when you think of a character artist or someone else, you're like, yep, that's who I look at all the time for inspiration, and like, maybe not like a mentor, but like, I mean, I think everyone has somewhere that goes, like ArtStation. Is there like a guy that you have tabbed that you're like?
Do I feel like you might be the same as me? Like, because throughout your career, you grow, right? You keep getting better.
Yeah.
So like, my inspirations constantly change. Because a lot of times, guys that I was looking up to before, I'm like better than them, but it doesn't impress me. Like,
yeah, exactly.
So I guess if we're asking about current.
And if not, that's totally fine too. I mean, I'm browsing all kinds of stuff all the time just for inspiration.
There's a guy for me, one of my biggest inspirations, most people would know him now, is Nihita Sumo, the guy that did Blame, a comic book called Blame.
Oh, he made a Netflix show about it. Yeah, it was really good, actually.
He did like a Wolverine Snicked series, which was the first time I think a lot of Western eyes saw him. I really love his work. I love his line. I love that stuff. But I've always kind of been, as a dude, the Tanaka book, Cannabis Works, he animated alongside Otomo and stuff on Akira and things. I'm kind of really influenced by a lot of like oddball, like Koji Morimoto, who at Studio 4 Degrees Celsius that did like Tekken Concrete.
Which is kind of funny, because I feel like Gearbox kind of has a little bit of those vibes on some of their games and stuff, which is kind of interesting. So.
Yes, probably because
I've been there for 11 years now, so I just push
my politics onto the youth.
So, really quickly, did you have one you can think of?
Kim Jong-ji.
There you go.
I think he's a god. So
yeah, absolutely.
Look him up if you don't
know. Well, so where can we find you guys' work? Do you guys have an art station or pages, portfolios, anything anywhere?
All my stuff, you can find me under Tentacles and Teeth.
Tentacles
and Teeth. Yeah, under my name. So you can just search that, and then you can find it.
Perfect. All right.
I don't really have anything online. I'm a hermit. I'm a weirdo. Most people don't even know. Yeah. I am on Facebook. I don't mind people getting in touch with me there. Just Scott Kester. You can search for me. There's some bad drawing up there that will be like, that's probably that guy. I've just been I'm just kind of a recluse, I guess.
Hey, nothing wrong with that. So. All right, well, we're going to wrap up this interview and get ready for the next one. So thank you so much for watching. This is Industry Drawings 2018 with some awesome concept artists. And check out their work. And thanks for watching.